Hi, this is Nag Reddy, Department of Mathematics, Oxford and Nivetha branches, Pathur and Inkol. Now I am going to explain about polynomials. First introduction, there is a flower bed in a garden which is in the shape of a triangle. Suppose AB is the longer side, the length of the longer side is 4 times of P and the length of the shorter side AC 2 more than P, that is P plus 2, and the length of the third side 3 times of P, that is 3P. Then perimeter of triangle ABC, perimeter is equal to sum of the lengths of all sides AB plus BC plus AC, that is equal to 4P plus 3P plus P plus 2. Add the variables 8P plus 2. One more example, there is a playground which is in the shape of a rectangle. We will find the area of the rectangle and the condition, the length is twice the breadth. Take the breadth as x units, that the length is twice means 2x and the area of a rectangle is equal to L into B, that is equal to 2x into x, that is equal to 2x square. Now I will define a polynomial. Here observe the example to 8p plus 2 and 2x square, both are called algebraic expressions. Polynomials are algebraic expressions containing some variables and constants. In the first example, p is the variable and in the second example, x is the variable. Containing some variable and constants and the coefficients operate on variables. Here 2 is the coefficient operate on variable x and here also 8 is the coefficient operates on p and the coefficients operate on variables which can be raised to the various powers of non-negative integers. Observe the power is 1 variable power, here also power is 2, both are non-negative integers. So polynomials definition, polynomials are algebraic expressions containing some variables and constants and the coefficients operates on variables which can be raised to the various powers of non-negative integers. Now I will explain some examples which are polynomials and which are not polynomials. Polynomials and which are not polynomials. For example, 3x square is a polynomial, the variable power is 2. But x power minus 2 is not a polynomial because the power is minus 2, which is a negative integer. Next, 2x square minus 5 is also a polynomial, but 1 by y minus 1 is not a polynomial. Y minus 1 whole power minus 1, the power is a negative integer. 3x cube minus 6x square plus 5x plus 7, which is also a polynomial, power 3, 2, 1, 0, is all are non-negative integers. But root of 2x is not a polynomial. The meaning is root 2 into x power half, which is not a positive integer. This is a rational number and hence it is also not a polynomial. So this is very clear which are polynomials and which are not polynomials. It is easy to observe whenever the powers are non-negative integers, they are called polynomials. Next, degree of the polynomial. The highest power of the variable of a polynomial is called degree of the polynomial. Observe the first example, the highest power is 2, 2 is the degree of this polynomial. Here also observe the power is 2 and 0, the highest power is 2, 2 is the degree of the polynomial. Here observe 3x cube minus 6x square plus 5x plus 7, the highest power is 3, 3 is the degree of the polynomial. 2x plus 3, the highest power is 1, 1 is the degree of the polynomial. 7u power 7 minus 5u power 10 plus 7. Here u is the variable, the powers are 7, 10, 1, the highest power is 10, 10 is called degree of the polynomial. Next, types of polynomials, first linear polynomial, 2x plus 3, what is the degree of the polynomial, degree is 1. Whenever the degree of the polynomial is 1, that is called a linear polynomial. The standard form of the linear polynomial is ax plus b, where a not equal to 0, a and b are real coefficients and x is the variable. So if the degree is 1, that is called a linear polynomial. Next, a quadratic polynomial. Quadratic polynomial means the degree 2, that type of polynomials are called quadratic. 2x squared minus 5x plus 3 are 5u squared minus 7u plus 6. These two are degree 2, they are called quadratic polynomial degree 2. The standard form is ax square plus bx plus c, a, b, c are real coefficients and x is the variable, a not equal to 0. Next, third one, the cubic polynomial. The cubic polynomial, example 5x cube minus 7. What is the highest power? 3. So whenever degree 3, they are called cubic polynomials. The standard form ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d, where a not equal to 0, a, b, c, d are real coefficients and x is the variable. One more example, 7y cube minus 5y square plus 2y plus 10, also a cubic polynomial. Then what about nth degree polynomial? Polynomials are generally denoted by px. Px nth degree means highest power is n, a0x power n plus a1x power n minus 1 plus a2x power n minus 2 and so on, an minus 1x plus an, where a0 not equal to 0 and a0, a1, a2 and so on, an minus 1, an are called real coefficients. So this is the nth degree polynomial, the highest power is n. So one more nth degree polynomial in the variable z, by taking the coefficients b0, b1, b2 and so on, bn. So first b0, the variable is z power n. Next b1, z power n minus 1 plus b2, z power n minus 2 and so on, bn minus 1 z and last term plus bn, and the condition b0 not equal to 0 and b0, b1, b2 and so on, bn are called real coefficients. Write examples of linear polynomials. So linear polynomials examples, 2x plus 3, 3x, these two are linear polynomials, degree 1. Quadratic polynomials, degree 2, 3x square minus 5x plus 6 or 7x square minus 5, 7x square minus 5. Cubic polynomials, example, 3x cube minus 7x square plus 6x plus 5 or 7x cube, only 7x cube, that is also cubic polynomial degree 3. What are the standard forms of linear polynomial? Ax plus b, a not equal to 0. Quadratic polynomial, ax square plus bx plus c, a not equal to 0. Ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. Next, we will discuss the value of the polynomial. Value of the polynomial. Take a polynomial px, suppose x plus 2. What is the p of 1? That is, put x value 1. 1 plus 2, that is equal to 3. So 3 is called the value of the polynomial px at x is equal to 1. What is p of 0? 0, put x value 0. 0 plus 2, 2. 2 is called value of the polynomial px at x is equal to 0. P of minus 2, put x value minus 2. Minus 2 plus 2, that is equal to 0. 0 is called value of the polynomial px at x is equal to minus 2. Next, suppose the definition px is a polynomial in x and put x value k, p of k is called value of the polynomial at x is equal to k.
Next, we will discuss the zero of the polynomial. Zero of the polynomial. Consider a polynomial px is equal to x plus 3. What is the p of minus 3? Put x value minus 3. Minus 3 plus 3, that is equal to 0. Whenever the value is equal to 0, then minus 3 is called zero of the polynomial. One more example, minus 3 is called zero of the polynomial. One more example, px is equal to x square minus 5x plus 6. Find p of 2, 2 square minus 5 into 2 plus 6, 2 square 4 minus 5 into 2, 10 plus 6, 4 plus 6, 10 minus 10, that is equal to 0. Here also p of 2 is equal to 0, then 2 is called 0 of the polynomial. Similarly, find p of 3, 3 whole square minus 5 into 3 plus 6, 3 square value 9 minus 15 plus 6, that is equal to 15 minus 15, which is equal to 0, then 3 is also called 0 of the polynomial. So here 2 and 3 are called zeros of the polynomial. Whenever it is a quadratic polynomial, its degree is 2, it has at most 2 zeros. At most 2 zeros. Whenever it is a linear polynomial, that is standard form ax plus b, the degree is 1, it has at most 1 zero. Whenever it is a cubic polynomial, degree 3, it has at most 3 zeros. So the number of zeros depends on the degree of the polynomial. Now I will explain some problems in the exercise 3.1. This is the homework exercise 3.1. First Roman A bit px is equal to 5x power 7 minus 6x power 5 plus 7x minus 6. Find the coefficient of x power 5. What is the coefficient of x power 5? This is the x power 5 term. What is the coefficient here? Minus 6. So the answer is minus 6. Degree of px. What is the degree definition? The highest power of the variable is called degree. The highest power 7, 5, 1, 0. The highest power is 7. 7 is called degree of the polynomial. The next bit, the constant term. What is the meaning of constant term? Without variable term is called constant. Observe the last one. There is no variable. That is called constant term. And minus 6 is the constant term. Next, B bit, write 3 more polynomials and create 3 questions. So, we will write one polynomial 2x cube minus 7x square plus 5. So, take a polynomial. My question is, what is the coefficient of x cube? The coefficient of x cube is 2. What is the coefficient of x? X term not there, but think 0 into x is there. Coefficient of x is 0. What is the degree of this polynomial? Degree is 3. What is the constant term? That is equal to 5. What is the coefficient of x square? Minus 7. Next, listen the third question. First, given pt polynomial with t, t cube minus 1. What is the p of 1? Put t value 1. 1 cube minus 1, 1 into 1 into 1, 1, 1 minus 1, that is equal to 0. Next, p of minus 1, minus 1 whole cube minus 1. Minus 1 whole cube value, minus 1, okay. So, minus 1, addition, minus 1, addition, minus 2. P of 0, 0 whole cube minus 1, 0 into 0 into 0, 0, minus 1, and the value is equal to minus 1. Next, fourth question, check whether minus 2 and plus 2 are the zeros of the polynomial x power 4 minus 16. Take this polynomial as p of x and find p of minus 2, minus 2 whole power 4, minus 16. This value, even number power, you will get plus 2 power 4, 16, minus 16, that is equal to 0. p of minus 2 is equal to 0. Therefore, minus 2 is the 0 of the polynomial. P of 2 is equal to 2 power 4 minus 16. Again, 16 minus 16, that is equal to 0. Plus 2 is also 0 of the polynomial. That's why minus 2 and plus 2 are the zeros of the polynomial. So, fifth question, the given polynomial Px is equal to x square minus x minus 6. Check whether 3 and minus 2 are the zeros of the polynomials. 3 square minus 3 minus 6, that is equal to 3 square value 9, minus 3 minus 6, 9, add the negative values, 9 minus 9, that is equal to 0, p of 3 is equal to 0, 3 is the 0 of the polynomial. Next, p of minus 2 is equal to minus 2 whole square minus minus 2 minus 6, that is equal to 4, minus 2 whole square 4, minus of minus 2 plus 2 minus 6, 6 minus 6, that is equal to 0. So minus 2 is also 0 of the polynomial. Hence 3 and minus 2 are the zeros of the polynomial. We will discuss the second question in the next episode. Thank you.